With 27 number one hits, including I Love a Rainy Night, Driving My Life Away, the number one duet with Crystal Gayle, Just You and I, Every Which Way But Loose, Someone Could Lose a Heart Tonight, You Don't Love Me Anymore, Pure Love, and Elvis Presley's 50th gold record, Kentucky Rain, he has garnered over 50 BMI awards and an unprecedented 10 millionaire awards. Ladies and gentlemen, Eddie Rabbit!
The song on the radio, but I gotta keep it rolling. Ooh, I'm driving my life away, looking for a better way for me. Ooh, I'm driving my life away, looking for a sunny day. The truck stopped cutie, coming on to me. Tried to talk me into a ride, said I wouldn't be sorry. But she was just a baby. Hey, waitress, pour me another cup of coffee. Pop it down, jack me up, shoot me out, flying down the highway. Looking for the morning. Ooh, I'm driving my life away. Looking for a better way. For me. Ooh, I'm driving my life away. I'm looking for a sunny day. The midnight headlight blind you on a rainy night. Steep grade of it. Slow me down and make it no. But I gotta keep rolling. There goes a windshield wiper, slapping out of tempo, keeping perfect rhythm with the song on the radio. But I gotta keep rolling. Ooh, I'm driving my life away, looking for a better way.
Thank you very much. Test, 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 test. Yeah, that's better. That's better. Sound like there was a foot on it before, you know? We're still kind of tweaking out first day back after 3 weeks. Bear with us a little bit here. How you all doing? Like say hello to everybody. Hello. Ooh, sounds good. Sounds good. Yeah, so I'm bringing two up a little, Juggy. Okay. How you doing? Got a little kids here in the audience today, huh? Hi, kids. Yeah. How old are they? What's so funny about that? Ask how old kids are. They all start laughing. Huh? Jeffrey is three. Oh, this is a whole family here? You know Jeffrey? Hi, Jeffrey. Jeffrey's looking up there at me. No, no, I'm here, Jeff. Jeff, come on, Jeff. How you doing? You're three? And how old are you, sweetie? Oh, she's cute. Got a little space between her teeth. How old? Say four. They tell you you're four? You really are two. They're just telling you. Nice to see y'all. I like these ladies here. Yeah, I guess we're back. Stand up, turn around, show everybody what I'm talking about. Look at this here. Isn't this nice? Yeah, look at here. Well, thank you. That's very fine. I signed them all? Okay, good. You can get some more over there, folks, when we get to the show. That's right. You want me to sign on that side? Okay, we'll do it. Yeah. We'll sign almost anywhere and almost anything, you know. Yeah. Promise? Yeah. Yeah, but that almost covers a lot of territory now. You know, some of the requests I get are, you know, cute. So we got any folks in Branson here tonight? Where'd everybody go? The smoke. I quit smoking and look what happened. They start blowing at me out of the tubes now. We got Branson people here? Yeah, nice to have you. What do you think, folks, about this place? Contractors must think they died and went to heaven in Branson, right? Unbelievable. Wonderful place. I love it here. I like to think of Branson also as having another idea in mind. It's where Americans come to find America again. What do you think about that, huh? At least I do. Anyway, it's good to have you here. Thank you for coming. We're going to play you some songs that I wrote tonight. And this is the Hair Trigger Band, famous, world-renowned band. I'll introduce you to these guys later. They're my best friends and a terrific band. We've been lucky enough over the years to have had about 26, 27 number one records. Thanks to a lot of you folks calling radio stations and buying our albums. We appreciate that very much. And here's one of them right now. I'm so glad that I met you, baby. And I'm so proud when we walk down the street. And I know it's crazy to worry like I do. But I get this feeling that I'm losing you. I get these suspicions. Even though I know that you love me, baby, and I really shouldn't feel this way. Ooh, suspicion. I can't help it, you're just so good looking. I'm afraid somebody's gonna steal you. Gene, everybody. Sound good, Gene? Ooh, suspicion. When I'm with you, I feel so satisfied. The way you touch me when you lay by my side. And that look you get in your eyes when we love, it makes me hate myself for what I'm thinking of. I get the suspicion, even though I know that you love me,
suspicion. I can't help it, you're just so good looking. I'm afraid somebody's gonna steal you.
How's it sound out there tonight? We okay? Just kind of checking the levels out there. Is it too loud? Is it too soft? Is it just right? Oh, all right, good. You like it? Kids like that too, huh? One more time. What happened? All right. Let's get this name Rabbit out of the way right away, especially for the kids, just in case they think I'm going to sprout ears and a tail here in a minute.
Well, you don't look like a rabbit to me.
The name Rabbit. Some folks want to know whether it's a real name or something I made up for showbiz, and I'm proud to say that Rabbit is a real name. It's an Irish Gaelic name. It's spelled R-A-B-B-I-T-T. My mom and dad come from Ireland, and it's a very Irish name. In Ireland, there's a lot of rabbits. I found out when I was a little kid, and I'm related to them. Now, I'll tell you a quick little story. Over in Ireland, they spell it with an E on the end. It's a Gaelic spelling, R-A-B-B-I-T-T-E. I asked my dad, I said, how come we get letters from the old country and from our relatives over there, and they spell it with an E, we don't have an E? And he told me that when he came into this country in 1924, passed the Statue of Liberty on that ship into Ellis Island, had his name tag on, R-A-B-B-I-T-T-E. He said, with this thick Irish brogue he was talking with, he said, now I walked into the building. They looked at me name tag, started calling me Ribbitty. And I didn't like it. So right then and there, I dropped the E and I said, it'll be Rabbit if you don't mind. So there's the story. I guess they put it on the front and called me Eddie, you know, so. I started out as a songwriter in this business, always wanted to sing his own songs, but you just don't go to Nashville and get discovered the day you hit town, at least I didn't. I gave some of my songs that I wrote away in the beginning to other people to record. Willie Nelson recorded one of mine called Who Put All My Exes in Texas. I don't know if you know this little known fact, I wrote Ronnie Millsap's very first number one record, first one he ever had. I mean, he's had about 20 or 30 since, but I wrote the first one. Did you know that? You didn't know that. I was just a little rabbit then. A little rabbit. Didn't even have a beard, I don't believe, then. Just a little cottontail, kids. Really? Would you like to hear it? All right. I'll do it on the guitar. Huh? Yeah, let me just do it on the guitar. You help me out a little harmony right there at the end on the word love, huh? Make it sound real nice. Now, don't blame me for this lyric. I was real young when I wrote this. Let me know if you've heard it now.
Pure love. Baby, it's pure love. Milk and honey and Captain Crunch and you in the morning. Pure love, you're the picture of pure love. 99 and 44, 100% pure love. 99 and 44, 100% pure love. Love.
You remember that? You can tell I was pretty young when I wrote that, can't you? Captain Crunch, that's right. Any guy who writes Captain Crunch and you in the morning, honey, make my day. You know, this is a young guy. Cereal and you, honey. You know? See, if I was a little older and a little wiser, I might have said something like Fiber One. You really move me, baby. I can tell we got some Fiber Wonders out there. Hey, it's good stuff. I fixed a hole in my driveway last week, but that stuff will never be the same again. I mean, just good stuff. I wrote a song for a guy who's not around anymore, but I'm sure we all remember Elvis. This is a song that made my mom and dad real proud, because before this song, I was just another long-haired kid with a guitar with a lot of big ideas and not a lot to show for it. And my dad worked in the boiler room of an oil refinery in Newark, New Jersey. Anybody from Jersey here? It's okay, you can say it. You got out too, huh? Nice to have you here. But anyway, my dad worked hard, worked a lot of hours like folks did back in those days, and didn't make a whole lot of money, but we got by. But I tell you what, when Elvis cut the song, it was a big deal around our house. I mean, they went bragging all over the neighborhood, and I was right behind them. This became Elvis's 50th gold record. Let me know if you've heard this one. Seven lonely days and a dozen towns ago, I reached out one night and you were gone. Don't know why you'd run, what you're running to or from. All I know is I want to bring you home. So I'm walking in the rain, thumbing for a ride on this lonely Kentucky back road. I've loved you much too long. My love's too strong to let you go. Never know what went wrong. Kentucky rain keeps pouring down, and up ahead's another town that I'll go walking through with the rain in my shoe. Searching for you in the cold Kentucky rain. Oh, in the cold Kentucky rain. Oh, in the cold Kentucky rain. Ooh, in the cold Kentucky rain. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now here's one I wrote for myself. You take that first step, ask her out and treat her like a lady.
Come on.
Second step, tell her she's the one you're dreaming of. Third step, take her in your arms and never let her go. Don't you know, step. Looks too beautiful to touch, but your heart keeps talking to you now. Don't give up. You think you see something in her eyes. You will never know until you try. You gotta take that first step, ask her out and treat her like a lady. Take a step, tell her she's the one you're dreaming of. Third step, take her in your arms and never let her go. Don't you know, step by step, step by step, you're in the road. First step, second step. You know, step by step, step by step. Thank you. Let's play some more songs for you. Chucky, give me a little more volume, will you? Here's some other number one records we have. Thanks to a lot of you folks out there. Songs that I wrote that we're proud of.
It'd be a lie to say I'm not gonna miss you. So please don't say goodbye now. Missed you one more time. And held you as I did when you were mine. My mom's favorite song that I wrote. I can't help myself. Here comes that feeling. Just like a raging river rushing over me. No, I can't help myself. Here I go falling. Head over heels, falling for you again. Head over heels, falling for you again. Hearts on fire, burning for each other. Too late now, we can't put out hearts on fire, fire, yeah. She ain't coming back to stay the night. She's just coming back to make things right, to tell me face to face the truth. She's found somebody new in her life. In her life. No, she ain't coming back to stay this time. She's just coming back to ease her mind. No, she ain't coming back to stay. She's coming back to say goodbye. She ain't coming back to stay. She's coming back to say. We must be doing something right. Cause baby, I'm still happy after all this time. You still bring out the best in me. And any fool could see that you and me, whoa, we must be doing something right. Make it. One more time, pour me another tequila. I don't wanna feel on my mind. Pour me another tequila, make it a killer. One more time, pour me another tequila. There's just no place in this world you can hide. You can't run from love when it's looking for you. All you can do is give up. You can travel in a time machine and disappear without a trace. It don't matter where you go, it's gonna find you. Just no place in this world you can hide. You can't run from love. Ooh. You can't run from love. There's just no place in this world.
Thank you, aren't you nice?
Yeah.
I know we got kind of a schedule to keep here. We've got so many kids in the audience, I felt like doing something for the kids, you know? And I'm trying to think of it. There's about two or three things I'm thinking of. What do you think about the pizza song? Should we do the pizza song for the kids? Kids like pizza? Yeah, don't we all? All right, I'm gonna do this for the kids. Let me hear the kids say, hey. One more time, hey. All right. We got any kids over here? It's all kids over here. Look at them all. All right. Anybody likes pizza? Say hey.
Hey.
All right. Well, then we're sold here. This is a little song. Now, we hadn't worked this up before, but when I see a lot of kids in the audience, I like to do something for them because a lot of these, you know, love songs and things, you know, just don't connect yet, you know. And, but this one will, I think. Yeah. Here we go. Let's see, key of D, wasn't it? Yeah. I can remember. He takes a wad of dough and he flops it on the table, makes it flat and round, then pours him a ladle of tomato sauce, spreads it red, thick, and sweet. He takes a big fistful of mozzarella cheese, spreads it around with anchovies, green peppers and onions and mushrooms and a little ground beef. Then he puts it on a shovel and shoves it in the oven with tender loving care. But then he dances around while her tongue's hanging out and the smell of heaven fills the air. Hey, dancing pizza man, make me the juiciest pizza in the land. Oh, hey, I'm no penny pincher, give me that big 16-incher. Whoa, make it to go. Hey, a dancing pizza man. Well, we sat in the booth less than a quarter of an hour, and out of the oven like a giant sunflower, it came all red and steaming with bubbling cheese. And then he took his round knife and he cut it up in slices, put it in a box, looked at me and said, the price is $3.99. I gave him a five, I got $1 change. And I was tempted to eat it on the front seat. It smelled so good I could hardly drive. So now excuse me, please, but I gotta have a piece of that scrumptious pizza pie. Hey,
dancing pizza man. Make me the juiciest pizza in the land. Hey, I'm no penny pincher. Give me that big 16-incher. Whoa, make it to go. Hey, dancing pizza man. Hey, dancing pizza man. Sure looks good. Hey, dancing pizza man.
For all the kids in the audience, whether you be 1 or 101, a holy plastic grail or something. I don't know. Anyway, sure tastes good. You doing okay? Hey, I think we won the kids over here. Say, you doing okay? Yeah. What happened to that big yeah? All right. Great. I want to sing you a song right now that I wrote when I was out of this country about 3 or 4 years ago, and it was for the very first time in my life. Amazing as it might seem, I'd never been out of this country before, and we're doing a record promotion tour of England, Scotland, Germany, Amsterdam. And after I was out about a week or 8 or 9 days, I got a little lonesome from my home, and I started to think about how far away I was from it and how I missed it. You know, my backyard, my wife, my 2 little kids. I got an 8-year-old boy and a 13-year-old daughter. No, she's great. And I got to thinking that there's a lot of great places to visit in this world, and it's really nice to go, but it's always good to come back to the USA, back to my backyard and my home, my little American town, Franklin, you know? And so I wrote this song in an Amsterdam hotel room one night, came back home and recorded an album called Jersey Boy. Didn't plan to release it as a single. It was just an album cut for the folks who buy my albums to see what I'm writing lately. About that time, the Gulf War broke out. A lot of people started to calling the radio stations wanting to hear this song. I appreciate that it meant so much to so many people at that time. Certainly wasn't written for that reason. Even got a nice letter from former President George Bush. Now that was some day, I'll tell you. I went down to the mailbox, walked down my little dirt driveway, going through the bills and the junk mail and all this, and there's a white letter there from the White House. So, I think, wow, that's pretty neat, you know, White House. What would they want with me? Then I thought about Willie Nelson, that letter he got from the government a few years ago, and I went, hey, you owe that we forgot to get from you last year. But anyway, it was a nice letter from George Bush. He had seen us on the, you remember the old Ralph Emery show? Used to be on there in Nashville Now, they called it on TNN. And we were on there, and he had seen us on there singing this song, and I said some nice things about George Bush, because I believe he's a real fine, decent human being, and I think he was a great president. In fact, I think he'd still make a great president. But anyway, I want to sing this song tonight for any American boys, American girls we have that are involved in Operation Desert Storm, if we have any in our audience, lest we forget the good job they did. Also want to sing the song tonight for some folks who came home from a nasty war 20-some years ago and didn't get quite the welcome home they should have got, the Vietnam vet. And how about the Korean vet and the World War II vet and the World War I vet, all the vets that go off to keep this place safe and great. Played boys. Hey, hey, hey. Come on. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey.
hey, 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 hey,
hey. All right. I wanna live in a place where the name of the kid's Billy. Turn on the radio and hear my man Willie. Friday night football, stand up and cheer. Go where I wanna go, I'm a free man here. I'm an American boy. Drive me a Chevy, ain't got no Peugeot. My older brother was a G.I. Joe. I'm red, white, and blue from my head to my toe. I'm an American boy. My little brother watched Saturday morning cartoons. I mowed the front lawn in the afternoon. Fixing up my car, I'm working for a living. Drive down to the seashore, looking at the pretty women. I'm an American boy. Drive me a Chevy, ain't got no Peugeot. My older brother was a G.I. Joe. Red, white, and blue from my head to my toe. I'm an American boy. Talk to me.
I have a dream, and so my fellow Americans.
One day,
ask not what you want, but your man. Ask what you want,
and I am free.
I'm an American boy. I buy American. I'm an American boy. Yes, I am. I'm an American boy. I'll die an American. I'm an American boy.
Let me hear the girls sing American Girl tonight.
I'm an American.
Oh, come on, girls, you can get louder now.
I'm an American.
Oh, that was good. One more, girls.
I'm an American.
I like it. Boys, jump in there.
I'm an American boy. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm an American boy. I'll die an American. I'm an American boy. I'm an American boy. Coast to coast, I'm an American boy. Just like apple pie, baby, I'm an American boy. Yeah, I'm an American boy. I'm an American boy.
I told him to put some tape up on there so I could see it. You know, I'm back there in the darkness, you know. So they put the tape on the outside of the curtain. I said, don't help me out there. I mean, you know. You having a good time so far? I hope so. We've got another half of the show that we're going to bring to you. It's got some songs that you'll like, and some great special effects coming up, so don't run away.
Don't forget to visit the gift shop on your intermission over there. There's a girl named Linda over there who's a dear friend and a great singer, by the way, who's got some stuff, some Eddie stuff over there. Right now, we got a fella who tells me he's lonely. He's from South Dakota. And I said, well, no wonder. No. You met him in the beginning of the show. He's a very talented guy. Maybe you haven't seen all of his talents at the beginning of the show, but you're going to see some great stuff now. He's going to prove to you that two or three heads are better than one. He's a very funny guy. Would you make welcome Jim Barber, everybody?
Gee, after all those fireworks, I'm kind of beside myself.
I know.
Well, thank you, Eddie. My name is Jim Barber. Yep, I'm Mr. Seville. Yeah, but you can call me Cato.
All right.
And we're very excited to be back again with Eddie.
Yep, by request.
Yeah, we kept requesting and they finally said, okay. But I remember our very first day in the area, though, we flew into Springfield.
Yep,
I flew first class. Yeah, carry on. And we didn't really remember how to get down to Branson, so we called up the Chamber of Commerce for directions, and they said, well, the town's growing so fast, just head south and follow the stretch mark. So we did.
Yep. I drove.
I steered. And we got into town and went by all the different theaters, drove down by the shores of beautiful Lake Perry Como, and there were three guys fishing there, and I think we scared them because they fell over backwards, almost drowned. We were so frightened, we just sat there like a couple logs.
I was petrified.
Yeah. Anyway, first guy came up out of the water, and without thinking, I just reached down, I grabbed him by the hair, and I pulled him up.
Yep, and the second guy came up.
Yeah, so I reached in, grabbed him by the hair, and pulled him up.
Yep, and the third guy came up.
Right.
So you grabbed him by the hair, and you pulled him out.
And I pushed him back under. He didn't have any hair. I thought he came up the wrong way. And then Andy Williams came walking by, looked down, started singing Moon River.
Oh, yeah?
Turned out the guy was a bald knobber. But we're very excited to be here tonight with Eddie. We're going to bring a little culture to the program.
Yes, opera.
Ooh.
I studied with Pavarotti. Figaro, Figaro.
Ooh. I studied with Elmer Fudd. Killed a wabbit, killed a wabbit.
Yeah.
Ooh. Sorry, Eddie.
Okay.
Anyway, I think we better go ahead and sing it.
All right, maestro, if you please.
Thank you.
All right. I am the tenor.
I'm a fiver. You sing it in Italian and I'll translate.
Okay. A che del vide, che del piacere, che del piacere, per andare. A dicolita.
See my grandma.
Dicolita.
She wears no bra.
Didn't they know?
Sorry.
Didn't they volgano? Don't need ragazzi.
Let's go play Yahtzee.
What?
Call
it Luca.
Go shoot a bazooka.
What?
Call a sanguigno. Go wash the window. Call it Luca. Wash a bazooka. Call a sanguigno. Shoot the window. Delicita.
Delicita.
Mr. LaBarbe. Figaro. I know this part. Judge Ito.
Oh
no. He thinks he's John Travolta.
Per carità.
Oh my gosh. Figaro.
E son qua.
What about me, Figaro?
Hey, son qua, Figaro la, Figaro la, Figaro la.
Figaro su,
Figaro
go,
Figaro su, Figaro good,
Figaro si ta,
Figaro su,
Figaro su, Figaro si ta, Figaro si ta, Figaro si ta, Figaro si ta. Here it comes, folks.
Out of the figure, out of the leash, out of the figure, out of the leash, out of the figure, out of the figure, out of the figure, Della si ta.
Della
the Godon, Della the Godon,
Della
the
Godon, Della
the Godon, Della the Godon,
Della the Godon,
Della the Godon, Della the Godon,
Della the Godon, Della the Godon,
Della the Godon, Della
the Godon, Della.
Thank you.
Barber and Seville.
That hurts me just to watch. There. Anyway, good evening. It's great to be back. I want to thank my alter egos, Barbara and Seville, for warming me up, and especially the great Eddie Rabbit for opening the show for me tonight.
Yeah. Thank you. Hi, Jeffrey. Hi. I'm this old.
Okay. What are you doing?
What?
You're supposed to be wearing a puppet.
I'm a nudist.
Oh, ooh.
I'm a Methodist.
Oh, well, excuse me. Cheers, everybody. Bull Shoals.
Can I have some?
Yeah.
Thanks. High dive. Whoa!
Ooh! It's refreshing. Anyway.
Get him out, he's drowning! Call 911.
I need your help.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, let's just get on with the program. Cheers, everybody. Welcome to the, I'm glad to be here tonight.
Thank you.
You're starting to wonder about me, aren't you? I can always sense these things. You're a very nice audience tonight. I welcome you all. Jeff, are you enjoying the show so far tonight? Jeffrey, you're an excellent ventriloquist. That's amazing. You know how old I am, Jeffrey? You know how old Eddie is? Anyway, well, you're a very nice audience. I guess I should explain, you know, you're probably wondering about me. I should explain why I became a ventriloquist, because we have some younger people. I don't want to be the reason for bad dreams tonight. But it all started when I was really young, this is true, growing up in the Black Hills of South Dakota. Tatanka. That's Lakota Sioux for buffalo. In fact, my Sioux name is Dances with Dummies. But, and the word Branson, that's Lakota Sioux for road construction. But, but while I grew up, though, my friends were concerned about me. This is true. They thought maybe I became a ventriloquist because my parents had been locking me in a closet or something, and it's not true. It was a footlocker. But as I grew older, I started finding myself, got more I could accept myself. I was having a lot of problems. I even had ringing in my ears, and then I got my head unlisted. But working here, though, with Eddie, I found out some new things that I really didn't know about myself. First of all, Eddie and I have a lot in common. We are both great animal lovers, of course, you know, since he's a rabbit. And and also, another word for rabbit is hair, and barbers work with hair. So this is perfect. You know, it fits in. So we thought we would do something new here at the Good Time Theater. I don't think any other theater in Branson has ever done this. We've teamed up with the local animal humane shelter, and every performance, we've been bringing out an unfortunate animal and adopting it to a lucky person in the audience. Yeah. Makes for a great ride home. And this afternoon, we gave away, this was kind of the, you know, they have unusual animals. We gave away a baby possum, and but today, though, they tell me they've got a cute, fuzzy little kitty cat. He's a big one. I guess it's a dog, a big dog. They've got him chained up. I'm going to go get him. Somebody is in luck. I'll be right back. Backstage. What is your name?
My name is Chico Pete.
Chico Pete.
See, my full name is Chico Territo Nogato Dorito Chihuahua von Beethoven.
Von Beethoven?
See, my mother was a Saint Bernard.
Oh. And your father?
A high jumping Chihuahua.
Oh.
They are still getting it.
Never mind. Half Chihuahua, half Saint Bernard.
See.
That's a very unusual combination.
Yeah. I have a friend who's half elephant and half rhino.
What kind of elephant is that?
Elephino.
Oh. Ooh. Oh, I'm sorry. Well, Mexican Chihuahua.
See. Si.
Did you bring your papers?
I am housebroken. I came from Los Angeles.
Oh, you did?
See, si. My owner, she ran away.
What was her name?
Rosa Lopez.
Oh. Why did she leave you?
I don't remember.
Okay, well, well, I welcome you to Branson.
Thank you, senor. I got a job.
You got a job in town?
At the gas station.
Really?
I pump the gas.
Yeah.
I check the oil.
Yeah.
And then I chase the cars.
Pretty good job. So you're going to stay here in town?
No, senor. I'm going to see my relatives down south where they eat tacos and speak Spanish.
Ah, Mexico.
No, Miami.
Oh. Well, before you go there, Chico, you might want to stop by our snack bar. We've got some great, you know, treats up there.
I have Chico treats.
Chico treats?
In your pocket. They're very good, senor. Try one. They'll make you dance.
Well, here, you have one. And
Try one, senor. You'll dance good.
Well, I don't need to, because see, dancing's in my blood.
I think he's anemic.
Yeah, here, go ahead and...
A whole handful, senor.
All right.
Living on the edge. More Chico treats.
More.
Hurry up.
Okay.
They call me Chico Pete. I'm the king of the rumba beat. When I hear it on the rockers, I go chee-chico-dum, chee-chico-dum.
Yes, sir, he's Chico Pete. And he's crazy for Chico treats. Then he starts to dance and everything goes cheek-cheek-a-boom, cheek-cheek-a-boom.
They give me zing and make me sing when I swing with this rumbero. It's very nice, so full of spice.
And when he's dancing, they bring Happy Ring the Vaqueros, singing a song
all the day long. So if you like the beat, take a lesson from Chico Pete. And I'll teach you to cheek cheek dum cheek cheek dum cheek cheek dum.
I'd like to learn.
Si, senor. I know that you would like the cheek dum cheek.
Yeah.
Come on, take a chance. Come on, do the dance. And Chico Pete doesn't teach you in a hurry like Arthur Murray. I come from Mexico. I work at Texaco. So, senor, I... Senor! Senor, did you eat a Chico treat?
Yeah. Hey, they're good.
Oh, no.
Here we go.
Ay, ay, ay.
They call me Mr. Feet. I'm in love with those Chico treats. Then I start to dance. Everything goes cheek, cheek-a-boom, cheek, cheek-a-boom. Excuse me, Mr. Pete.
See?
Do the doggies have a different beat?
See?
If they do, will you teach me to cheek, cheek, cheek-a-boom, cheek, cheek-a-boom?
Si, senor. I know that you would like the Chico Doom Cheek.
Yeah, man. It's very nice.
Yeah, dog. So full of spice. Just take your hand upon my paw, and then just move my jaw, and we will try.
Just you and I. So if you like the beat, take a lesson from Chico Pete.
And I'll teach you to cheek Chico Doom, cheek Chico Doom, cheek Chico Doom.
Chico!
Gracias!
Well, I think I'll keep him for myself. He's too cute. We did find something, though. Elvis from the parking lot just brought this back. If it's a blue gym bag, if this belongs to you, it was left out near one of the big buses. We'll just have it over here by this exit after the show. And... Been in the cabbage patch a little long. A little ripe, too. Can you pull your thumb out?
Mm.
Just pull your thumb.
Mm.
Just pull.
Mm.
Hi, baby.
Hi, Daddy.
Yeah, no. I'm Jim. We need to find a babysitter.
Look at the phone.
The phone?
Right there.
Ooh, okay. That's the tiniest phone I've ever seen.
It's a lady phone.
Ah.
It's cordless. Like a baby.
Yeah.
Thank you, thank you.
He likes baby jokes.
Hurry up.
Hello.
I'll get it.
Hello. It works. Who is it? Dial a joke?
Yeah, I called him.
Oh, good.
1-900-RIP-OFF.
Yeah. You have a joke for the baby? What kind of diapers do rich babies wear?
I know that one. Gucci. They say Gucci, Gucci, Gucci. Thank you.
Good joke. Rich babies wear Gucci diapers.
Yep. If they're filthy rich.
They're filthy rich.
Yeah. Ah. And loaded.
Yeah, well. Baby.
I'm getting hungry.
Oh, I did see something in the bag.
Oh, good. Fill her up.
All right.
In the ear.
Okay.
Milkshake.
Milkshake. Listen, I better.
You want to try some?
No, I have my own brand. It's good.
All right. Lake water?
Yeah, you want some?
No, thanks.
All right.
I'm getting homesick.
Well, I know. I don't know where your mommy is. I'll tell you what I do when I get homesick, and maybe this will work for you, baby. You, when you go to bed tonight.
I need my blankie.
Blankie?
In the bag.
Excuse me.
Oh, blankie.
Can you share with Jeffrey?
Uh-huh.
All right. Well, you get your blankie, you close your eyes, imagine you hear some beautiful music, and you take yourself back home in your dreams.
Day is ending, birds are wending back to the shelter of each little nest they love. Nightshades falling, lovebirds calling. What makes the world go round? Nothing but love. When whippoorwills call and evening is nigh, I hurry to my blue heaven. A turn to the right, a little white light will lead you to my blue heaven. You'll see a smiling face, a fireplace, a cozy room.
I can't breathe.
A little nest that's nestled where the roses bloom. Just Molly and me.
Who's Molly?
And baby makes three.
That's me.
We're happy in our blue heaven. When whippoorwills call
to sleep, I do fall.
And evening is nigh,
my blankie and I.
We're happy in our
blue
heaven.
Blankie.
I turn to the right.
I need my nightlight.
A little white light.
I can't sleep tonight.
Will lead you to
my
blue blankie
heaven.
You'll see a smiling face, a fireplace, a cozy room.
Ha-ha.
A little nest that's nestled where the roses bloom.
Just Mommy and me.
Just Molly and me.
And Daddy makes three.
And my baby makes three. We're happy in our
happy in our
blue, happy in our
heaven. Good night.